embarked on the IWC scene in the summer of 2005, when his matches against the likes of Jason Doria and Jimmy DeMarco became an instant fan favorite and was brought back after high demand, Chris Maverick, from many of these fans. And we're about to see another international star as his opposition.
I'm liking this music, Joe Dombrowski. I'm liking what I'm hearing.
Certainly an individual that has a lot of parallels to yourself and your client, Mr. Shima Zion, about to make his way through the curtain momentarily.
And ladies and gentlemen, this begins IWC debut, and from Sydney, Korea.
That is one good-looking man, I gotta say. I don't mean that in a gay way, but... Oh, and what a cute doggy! Look at the dog, that's so adorable!
What dog?
The dog he's got!
That's not... That looks like a leash to me.
I don't
see anything attached to it. Call me crazy.
What
kind is it?
Huh?
What kind of dog is it?
Look at him. See, you just put the dog in the ring. That's adorable.
How did that...
I want to get a dog like that.
How did that dog leap on the apron?
He picked the dog up and he's done it in the...
That's so cute. How's he holding him up just by his chin like that?
It's a little tiny dog. It's one of those little toy dog things. I don't know dogs. I'm sorry.
First it's a dog, and now it's a toy dog. I don't see a dog.
Ladies and gentlemen, this contest is one for all. It is a Super Indy V qualifying contest.
Bryce Dunsberg, the assigned official here, and I don't know what in the world he's going to do with this quote-unquote dog, as Chris Maverick claims.
There you go.
The nice threads, too. I mean, I like this Milano Collection AT guy.
Well, certainly you do know fashion, and Milano, also known the world over for some modeling successes, as is Shima Zion. So maybe you two can get together and exchange some tips.
I wouldn't mind that. I mean, I wonder who, I'm going to have to give him a call later, see who represents him. He's out of Italy, I believe, right?
I believe so.
Yeah, but clearly Italian.
Whether it's the United States, Mexico, Japan, or Europe, Milano Collection AT is well known all over the world. Very established star, very skilled. You could say the same thing about Kudo, as you see the collar and elbow tie-up. Kudo, a former King of DDT tournament winner, a former competitor here in IWC, as you mentioned, in 2005.
Yes.
And was brought back after high demand from all of our fans here in the IWC. And furthermore, this is a Super Indy 5 qualifying matchup. And we got to talk for a minute about Super Indy 5, April 15th here at the Court Time Sports Center. 8 stars already involved. It's going to be Petey Williams, Matt Seidel, Ricky Reyes, Shannon Moore, Glenn Spector, Troy Lords. I know you're not too happy about a few of those names, but those are the 6 involved in this tournament thus far. And whoever wins this matchup is going to be number 7. And, of course, later tonight, Jason Gorey and Claudio Castagnoli will do battle to determine that 8th seed, but very high stakes going on in this matchup right now.
Yeah. I don't know. I mean, this could go either way. Both fine competitors. Either one would be a great addition to Super Indy 5. Not quite as good an addition to Shima Zion.
Quite a shame he's not involved, isn't he?
It's a tragedy.
He couldn't buy his way or worm his way in there.
But I'm here. What I want you to do, write your congressman tonight. I want you to write your congressman and complain the travesty of Justice King.
Look at innovative offense by Milano, using the ropes to his advantage.
Breaks it. Waits till 4 to break the count.
Deep arm drag takeover. Milano about 6'2", 6'3", has the definite height advantage.
Does Milano speak English or only Italian?
Well, I'm not too familiar with him, to be quite honest. I haven't had many conversations with him.
That's a good homework. I mean, aren't
you? Well, I do research.
You're like the lead commentator here.
Well, I am, yeah. Well, hard to not be when none of the others show up, but that's...
I'm here.
Well, that's true, but you wear many hats here in IWC.
I wear many hats.
We couldn't expect you to devote your full time to this.
Have you noticed that I don't have a hat on today?
I've noticed a lot about your hair, but we had action.
Nice.
The pace quickening, another deep arm drag. And the crowd appreciates this athleticism.
How could you not?
Very impressive. And you got to believe both men would definitely be very deserving of a spot in Super Indy 5. the most watched IWC show every year traditionally.
He's
and using
like
those
a reverse Texas no.
He's hog tying and he's using the ropes
in
to his advantage again.
That's a wow. That's something though.
He's got him completely tied up in the ropes. Kudo cannot unseat
him. Do you get a count here? Because I mean,
well, he's not touching him.
That's what I'm saying. Milano's not using the ropes.
Look out! Flying charge buries both feet into the upper body.
Stick a fork in him. He's done. I like that. Take a moment. Fix the hair for the camera. Yeah. That's
should have taken a few moments to fix your hair there.
What are you talking? This is great hair.
Please.
I know.
Wait a second.
You're gonna have your hair just like this next week, please.
Okay. Kudo back up, standing dropkick takes down Milano.
See, that's uncalled for. The man was taking a moment to fix his hair.
Oh, I mean, well, excuse me.
It's very important to look good in the ring.
The spot in Super Indy 5 on the line. It's not about hair. And there's that stiff kicks, hard strikes, trademark of Kudo we saw many times here in 2005 in IWC.
Ooh.
A second one. Right to the spine of Milano Collection AT, and now Kudo, the DDT standout, starts to take control of his adversary.
I'm amazed Kudo's even awake after that kick to the head he took a moment ago.
Branching that arm hard.
But he seems to have taken control of this matchup, Joe.
Kudo's isolating one particular body part. And still continues to kick away. Have you seen any athlete in IWC history, with the possible exception of a Loki or someone of that mold, who is as quick on their feet as Kudo?
Shima's pretty fast. Oh. And Kudo, he's up there. I mean,
Shima's pretty fast. I should have saw that one coming.
Well, just saying.
Kudo has that arm barred still.
I'm gonna slouch myself.
Wrenching it back, direction that's not meant to go in, but Milano back up to his feet.
Shots to the kidneys there.
Charged in, roundhouse by Kudo. Caught him right up around the facial area. And you know, models don't like that.
Yeah. No, I mean, if I were representing Milano, and I'm not, I mean, I wish I were a good-looking man, but if I were representing Milano, I would sue Kudo for that.
Oh, lawsuit. Give me your business card after the show.
That's kind of a Tung Sudo roundhouse to the face. Studied Tung Sudo myself, you know.
Oh, really?
I did. Mini martial arts.
Ooh,
nice chop.
In the corner, and you can hear.
Did you hear that?
The reverberation of that kick off the body of Milano Collection AT. You know, Milano Collection AT is so popular, he spawned a miniature version of himself in some areas of the world, Milanito Collection AT.
Ooh. We should get him here.
Oh, well. Maybe you can scout him. Maybe you can represent him.
Hey.
Is there a mini Chris Maverick running around?
One would hope.
Oh.
Everything is better with midgets.
Wasn't necessarily referring to midgets, but
minis, dwarves, or little people.
Well, Milanito doesn't fit any of those adjectives, politically correct or politically incorrect, but that's that trademark double knees into the corner by Kudo. Dave's Milano Collection AT. And now Kudo starts to take over and back to that arm. Sends him in. Charging one more time, but Milano meets him to the punch there with a kick right to the midsection. Elevates him up and over.
Lands on the
with a block. Kick to
there's
the side of the head. Dazes Milano with a jumping Enziguri style kick. Kudo was about 6, 7, 8 feet in the air, and Milano still connected with his head.
Apparently they teach martial arts in Italy too, Joe. Right there.
No doubt about it. Milano knows that all that strength, all that feeling is being sapped out of that arm of his. He needs to start moving around. He needs to keep Kudo away from that arm. He needs to daze him and keep him grounded. And that's the strategy he's taking into account right here as Bryce Remsburg administers that obligatory 10 count.
You got a one under their feet. Both kind of wobbly here, though.
Milano counters the right hand, hits a few of his own, and another knife edge. And Kudo, the only reason Kudo's still standing is because he had that turnbuckle to fall back into. For the ride, handspring, back elbow. Great agility into a modified bulldog. And usually you don't see guys this tall doing moves quite like that. A lot of the charge in. Running senton. Gets the lateral press, deep hook, count of two. Milano was 1 second away from qualifying for Super Indy 5. Well, Super Indy has a rich history of international flair. Kudo baits him in with that enziguri kick. Oh, we saw this last year. Kudo gonna clamp on that body scissors and stretch away at the arms.
Illegal move here. Counting.
We saw
working
him
there you go. Working the five count.
Nice. O'Connor nice roll. Beautiful there. Bridge. Almost got a count of three. We saw Milano using the ropes to his advantage earlier in the matchup, and now Kudo returning the favor.
And both men know how to work the four count. You have a five count of release.
Matrix is out of the clothesline. Tremendous agility by Milano. Kudo up and over the clothesline attempt there. Backslide attempt, drives with the legs. No, but for a second, Kudo was in Super Indy. Oh my God, a hard kick to the temple. That's gotta knock the man out.
Kudo's out. Kudo's got this one.
He's done, no, another kick out.
How about that was it right there, Milano. Kind of an involuntary muscle twitch to kick out there.
But think about some of the great Japanese talent we've had in Super Indies in the past. Soldier, Anru, Akudo, Hidaka. One of these men will join that prestigious list tonight. Look out. Double knees!
It could be the Italian. Might not be the Japanese guy. Might
very
be
well
Italian.
Could. Well,
he's Italian, you see, like Tracy Smothers.
Oh, like Tracy Smothers. Certainly he's got some Japanese in him as well. Jumping into Guri.
Kudo's still on his feet.
If Kudo would have hit those double knees, this match would have been over. Wait a second. Packaging him together. Drops him. Face first. Three count. Yes. Milano's in Super Indy.
I need to get that guy in my card. He's got some talent there.
Sonny's got a ton of talent.
With the right guidance, he could go places.
Well, he's going places right now. He's going right back to Elizabeth, PA, right back to the Fort Times Sports Center, April the 15th, because he joins that prestigious list in Super 85, and hopefully by the time he gets there, you haven't brainwashed.